even though we don't have at this time Ms. Frances Moore, I would like to start my address by recognizing her as if she was present. So Mrs. Frances Moore, President and CEO of IFPI. I don't see Blaze here, but still, he has done a lot to put this seminar together. So I'd like to recognize Blaze Fernandez from IMI as well. Senior representatives from IFPI and IMI, panelists and speakers, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of FICCI, it is my privilege to warmly welcome you all to this digital piracy seminar being organized in collaboration with IFPI and the Indian music industry. The principal purpose of this event is to engage in a comprehensive interaction on the global and Indian music landscape, the significant adverse effects of digital piracy on all stakeholders, and the challenges posed in combating piracy, the evolving jurisprudence on intermediaries' liabilities, and the likely impact on key players in the industry. It is a matter of great satisfaction that we have been able to bring together here in this seminar a very distinguished body of experts and participants to discuss these issues. But with your permission, allow me to introduce these issues very briefly. Ladies and gentlemen, creativity and human endeavor fuel the progress of mankind. And effective IP protection, particularly through copyright and neighboring rights, recognizes and rewards individuals for their creativity. From a broader global perspective, as seen through 42 country studies done following the methodology of my earlier organization, the World Intellectual Property Organization, the copyright industries in these countries have on an average contributed 5.18% to their respective GDPs, and on an average of 5.32% to employment generation. This shows not only a strong correlation between copyright industries and GDP and employment, but also other indices such as Global Innovation Index and Global Competitive Index. According to a recent FICCI Ernst & Young study of 2019, the media and entertainment industry in India is estimated to have revenues approximately $25 billion, and for a culturally